Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we shall learn how to use data from a random sample to draw inferences about a population. Now let us suppose that there is a school that surveyed 180 students about their favorite sport. And out of these 180 students, 62 students like to play baseball. Now the question is, what conclusion will be drawn from the given data if there are 1,800 students in the school? Is this conclusion valid? And from the above data, we are given that 62 students like to play baseball, and we can now find the number of students in school who like baseball from the sample. Now the number of students denoted by N is equal to the number of students who like to play baseball, that is 62, upon the number of students surveyed, which is given by 180, multiplied by the total number of students in the school, that is 1,800, and therefore the number of students, that is N, is equal to 620. So we can conclude that 620 students in the school like baseball, now we'll check validity of our conclusion. Here the sample is random. Because 180 students were randomly chosen without favoritism or preference, it represents the population of the school students. And the sample is large enough. With all these conditions, we can say that the sample is reasonable. So, the conclusion drawn is valid. And in this way, we can draw the inferences about the population from the data of the sample. And we should note that if the sample is not reasonable, then we cannot draw any valid conclusion. Let us consider one more example. The employer randomly surveys 10 employees from each floor of its company's building to determine number of employees who come by carpool to each office. Of these 24% say they carpool, what conclusion will he draw? Here we see that the sample constitutes 24% of the 10 employees from each floor of the company's building. Since the sample here is randomly chosen, so valid conclusion can be drawn and thus he concludes most of his employees do not carpool . Thus, we can say that we can draw valid conclusion regarding the population from the data of a random sample. Now we'll see we can also use data of the sample to compare unknown characteristics of two populations.
Suppose we are given two random samples. That is sample A and sample B. Of grades 7 and 8 respectively, that is sample A is for grade 7 and sample B is for grade 8, and average height for sample A is given to be 4 feet and that of sample B is given to be 4.7 feet. Now the question is, what inference can we draw from the two samples regarding the height of students? Here we see that average height or mean height of grade 7 students is 4 feet and mean height of grade 8 students is 4.7 feet. Thus, we infer that height of grade 8 students is greater than height of grade 7 students. Thus, we conclude that grade 8 students are taller than grade 7 students. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.